there's one thing we learned, it's that we're not good at fake sleeping. We know this.
I'm good at sleeping.
I'm so sleepy.
Why are you so sleepy?
Because I haven't had any coffee yet.
Oh. I'm always sleepy.
I'm not really sleepy.
I'm hungry, too.
I'm always hungry, for sure. And I'm always up for felting. Really, really excited about this project. We're going to make these little sleepy mice. And you're going to become addicted to it. So make sure you have plenty of time. And they're so tiny, I don't know if you can even see them.
They're perfectly bite-sized.
They're perfect. And if we could just infiltrate the world with these, there would be world peace, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
Especially if like puppies could deliver them around. So puppies and sleepy mice.
Yes.
And kittens.
Yes.
There would be no strife. So this is a supply pack. We got our supply pack over here. And it's a huge supply pack. It's bigger than my head. This is almost as big as the pumpkin supply pack, which was for sure bigger than my head. Because it's full of enough core wool and top coat to make, oh my gosh, probably a dozen or more mice. And you can make two sizes. So we're going to work on the bigger size today, just for the ease of demonstration. And that's done on the Zoli tool. I didn't bring a Zoli tool out here, but you'll see. And then the little size, so these are about 3 inches total. And then the little size is more like 2 inches, and this is done on a skewer. But same exact technique. So there's a lot to do with these little guys. So we should go get started, unless you have some exciting mouse jokes.
There's always some humor.
All right.
What is a mouse's favorite game?
I don't even know why I pretend to try to guess. I don't know what.
Sometimes you get them.
Sometimes.
Hide and squeak.
Hide. That's not fun.
They're all funny. Ask people. They love them. All
right. We should start.
Yes.
All right. Wake up. I'm awake. Don't wake the mice. Milo's creeping around the table too. This is the supply pack. It's probably gonna take a minute for the camera to focus on it because it's so huge. We have all of our accent colors, rots and rots of them, and a big bundle of off-white core. So we're going to make the Zoli tool mouse, which is the 3-inch mouse, approximately. I like this one because he's like super curled up. So it's like this. Here's another one that's not quite as curled up. And to do this, you need a Zoli tool. If you don't have the Zoli tool, you could use a pencil. Perhaps try a pencil, but this is a little bit thicker than a pencil, but just so you know. So you're going to start with about an 8-inch piece of your off-white core. So 2, 4, 6, 8. And you're going to quarter it. Now this feels a little thinner, Milo, than what we used. So we may have to add probably add a little bit of wool. We'll see. We'll see. And then you're going to wrap the Zoli tool. You're basically going to wrap a head and wrap a body right onto the Zoli tool. So I'm going to take one of my quarters. I'm going to make sure I'm very tight and consistent. That's important because this makes this shape, and then that's it. I mean, it doesn't get much else done to it. So it needs to be well wrapped. So I go around the straight part of the tool, and then I angle towards the facet of the point, and then I'm going to angle back. And I want to get that angle in and back a couple of times. So that is basically the mouse head. This is the back of the head, and this is the nose. Oh my gosh, my stomach's growling already.
People should notice that you are pulling pretty tight, and you are drafting the wool out as you go.
Yes,
And I'm keeping my other fingers right here because what tends to happen is your shape wants to drift back. We don't want to let it drift back. We want it to stay right where it is. And so now I have this nice, consistent little kind of bullet shape. So if I feel like I just want to make sure that's going to stay, I can stab around a little bit, not too much. You're going to take a second quarter and wrap the body. And this is just a subtle crisscross. So as I come around, I angle to the right, then I angle to the left, then I angle to the right. And this is definitely going to take at least two pieces. I want the body and the head to be about the same size, but like I said, this wool is a little on the thin side. So I'm gonna get another one on here. All right, so my wool just separated there because I wasn't holding it close enough. So I wanna make sure I pull this nice and tight and finish it out. And then rather than starting back with that little half piece of wool, I'm gonna pick up my fourth quarter. So at this point, I have one, two, and half of the third, and this is my fourth piece. So with my fourth piece, I'm gonna go around the body and I'm gonna come up and go around the back of the head. So this kind of joins the two shapes together. And depending on how thick your wool piece was, this might be your third piece does this. So you have one for the head, one for the body, and then the third piece goes around the body and brings the head together. But basically, this is a good inch wide, and you can see what the shape should be. So I'm gonna slide that off. And then I can kind of look at it and decide where I want the top of the head to be. So I'm gonna let this be the top of the head. So I'm gonna go ahead and fold that over and start getting the curl and just stab in the neck area to start to establish that little curled up shape like that. And then using a strong needle, which would be, you could use either the 38 or the 36. You're gonna stab back on this point of the nose to start to create the indent and the mouth. Can you see that?
I just zoomed.
Oh, good. So I'm just gonna stab back on the underside point of the nose here with a strong needle. And this has a lot of give to it because it was just a simple wrap on the tool. So that might automatically make a little kind of smile or so I'm just staying right in the center. You know, Milo, I really like the eyes. I really like the little poofy eyes, so I think I'm gonna add that.
Oh, all right.
Yeah. So this is one without the poofy eye. We just put the sleepy eye right into this head shape. And then this is one that does have a little eye poof. We put the sleepy eye into that. So we'll add that little step. Okay. Now we need to make the little thighs. And that would either be, your fourth piece, your fourth quarter, split into two pieces, but since we don't have that, I'm gonna pretend I'm gonna make a quarter and I'm gonna split it into two pieces this way. So basically two 4-inch pieces. And you just wrap a simple 1-inch just straight around the Zoli tool. You're just making a rectangle on the flat part of the Zoli tool. I'm just going straight around. I want to be able to get around at least two or three times Then you slide those off. You have these little rectangular pillows, and they make these little thighs. So you want to let the back of the rectangle just blend into the back of the mouse. So they just kind of taper and meet on the back. And then the ends of the rectangle, other end, comes here, and that's where the feet go. And then the end of the wrap part of the initial piece we made is like the little butt. This is why it's so cute, because it gets a little feet and a little butt and little everything. So now we have our basic shape. We've got the beginnings of our, you know, shape of our face. And we need to make our pink parts. Only in needle felting do you get to make precious pink parts.
Legitimately.
Legitimately. It's not something you would normally do, maybe.
Okay.
We need a tail. One tail. 2 feet. 2 ears. And 1 nose. So we're going to take a really thin strip of this lovely house carded bat and get about a 6-inch piece. I'm going to give it a little tug because I had a thick spot there. I want it to be nice and thin but consistent. And then, so when I stretched it now, look, it's 8 inches. So these measurements are subject to these kinds of changes. We want to wrap on a skewer, 3 inches. So I just start 3 inches back and wrap to the tip and then come back. So it needs to be very consistent with a little bit of overlap and you have to go out and back, because what's going to happen is we're going to slide this off of the skewer and it needs to keep its shape and not unravel. So this takes a little bit of practice, really. This is a really good beginner project, but you're definitely going to get better and better at it the more that you do it. So I know that I need to get all the way back, so I'm stretching this out a little bit because I can tell that I'm not going to make it if I don't. Alrighty. So before I slide it off, I'm going to encourage it to stay together by just pressing firmly between my palms. Creating some heat.
How does a mouse feel after it takes a shower?
Squeaky clean?
Yes! Ding ding.
The mouse jokes are going to be a lot of squeaks, huh? Just like the donkey jokes?
Well...
Or a lot of ass.
I think maybe, yes.
So I'm going to slide it off, and then before I roll it in my palms again, I'm just going to give it a couple of passes of stabbing. Because I just want to make sure it stays before I... All right, so this will stay put. Oh, that's a good long one. Because now these fibers are, you got fibers going each way, and they are now felted together. All right, the little feet are fun to make, and they're super easy. I'm going to take a similar amount of the pink, and I'm going to split it. So this is a 6-inch thin piece. I'm going to make it into 2 3-inch pieces, and I'm going to wrap my skewer. So I'm just going to wrap around one section, you know, one area, and make this little seed. Make sure that stays put. I can do both at the same time.
If you make it too tight,
You won't be able to shape it, right?
Yeah, it's okay. It needs to be tight enough to hold its shape. So I'm not pulling super, super tight on this, but you don't want it to be wimpy either. Okay, so we've got our 2 feet. I'm just going to set these pieces aside and make all the pieces, and then we'll put them onto the mouse. So now we need to make ears. And for the ears, we want to stack 2 sort of thin but consistent 2-inch squares of the pink. So restacking, this is called restacking. It just helps you get all the wool lined up as well as possible. So like if this is a little stretched out and weird and I'm going for a square, I will restack. All right, I feel like this one just need a tiny bit more to each one. Okay, so this shape we're gonna make onto our felting surface, and I've got my fibers aligned and horizontal in these 2-inch squares. And I'm gonna use my pen tool. If you just have a single needle, that's fine. But basically you're gonna draw about the size of a dime, a little circle. Are you pretty close on this one?
I can get closer.
Yeah.
You might have to scoot the stavet up. Little more. That's pretty good.
Okay. So I drew my little circle. First I want to roll, I left, you know, about 1/8 of an inch of some fiber off the top of the circle. So I want to roll that down into the circle. And then I want this fiber on the edge to roll into the circle, so that all the fiber fringe is pointing down. Now, before I go crazy stabbing, I'm going to pull it off of my felting surface. Whether you're using a Stab-It-Wabbit or foam, it's still important not to embed a piece that you're felting directly into your felting surface. So you've got to lift it up once in a while. So let me do this other one. I'll move it over. See, am I centered there?
You're perfectly centered.
So this technique, I mean, you can make any shape ear with this layout, this horizontal fiber that you're folding into place. I mean, if you made it long and skinny, you're making a rabbit ear, you know, or a deer or a donkey or a kangaroo. So now that I have them at least started, I'm gonna really flatten it out with my punch tool. And the punch tool has 5 needles. They're more spread out, so they're really good for these flat surfaces. And they're finer needles, so they leave a more kind of finished look. And see, I'm not felting this bottom fringy part. So if your ears turned out huge, you have an opportunity to make them smaller, because the next thing we want to do is give them a little pucker at the base of the ear. So you could pull a little bit of fiber off if you need to, just make sure you hold this firmly. You could pucker farther up the ear to make the ear smaller, but I like mine right about there. So I'm just gonna fold that like a taco and felt from the sides to make the pucker stay together. I could say something funny with pucker, but
with pucker,
everyone's pucker is a fun word. Pucker's fun to say. A little pucker. Okay. Good. So now we have 2 feet, 2 ears, a tail. The nose is so teeny tiny, it's really going to be hard to see. Are you still zoomed in?
I am very zoomed.
It's kind of, it's a little tricky. Actually, I think I'm going to wait on the nose because I can't set it down. So I have this tiny little 1/4 inch stacked of pink here, but I'm going to set it aside because I don't want to fold it until I'm ready to put it on. Okay. You can probably zoom out a tiny bit. Okay, the feet. Well, let's do the tail first. That's a piece of cake. I usually look for, is there a thin side and a thick side? And I might put the thicker end. Basically, you're just going to felt the end onto the back where those two thighs came together. This pen tool, the reason I switched, this pen tool has two needles in it. It just goes in easier and it's a little bit more delicate, so it's just easier to use on a project like this. This one has three needles, a lot more grab, and it was pulling too much. I didn't like it. All right, so the tail is felted onto the back and just sticking out right near the butt and the thighs. Now, the feet get felted onto the little ends of the thighs here. Oh my gosh, my stomach. So you could make them, these kind of point to one side, you could make them pigeon-toed, you could make them splay out, and sometimes you start stabbing and they just kind of do what they're gonna do. So I just stab one end in, and I can kind of use this fringe on the end of the thigh to further hold the foot in. And then the other end, I'm gonna take a needle and just make sure that it's rolled over. That one's a little strong. And it's not gonna keep fraying, because remember, this was just a wrapped piece on the skewer. So this is a 40 gauge, which is more fine and can just finish off and felt this edge without, you know, felting so much.
I'm zooming for the next one.
Okay, all right, so strong needle first to get it stuck. Hear that crunch? Can you hear it? Can you hear it? So it's really stabbing it in there. And then a finer needle to fold that little toe over. Round that end out a little bit. All right, tail's on, feet are on. What do we need to do next? Let's put the little eye bumps on, and I'm just gonna use the off-white. And I need about a little 2-inch piece. This was a quarter. This was a quartered piece of my chunky core. And I'm gonna split that in half. And I think this is probably still a little much. And I'm gently, loosely, actually, I'm gonna fold this in my hand. The reason is, if I wrap the skewer, it's gonna be very tight. I want it to be like a soft pillow so that I can shape it once it's on. All right, this is too much, so I'm gonna split it into two. So now I have 2 1-inch pieces. Just want a little piece that you can gently fold into about a 1/4-inch little ball. And that goes on the side.
Why was a mouse afraid of water?
I don't know, why?
He heard about the catfish. The catfish. Mice are scared of cats. It's a natural order of things.
He heard about the catfish, so he was afraid of water. Yes. Yes. Maybe we should go to mouse proverbs. Did you find
it? I did not look up any mouse proverbs.
All right, so these look like, he looks like a little embryo, like his little eyes are closed. So these are kind of off on the side of the head, about halfway between the nose and the back of the head. I need to stab my nose back a little bit before it. Okay, now we can put the ears on. So you kind of poof out the fringe at the other end of the pucker. And the ears go
at the back of the head. Not like, you know, you don't want them down the neck. You want them on the head. But there should be some space between the eye and the ear. Think I'm going to finish this in 35 minutes? This is like a...
Yes.
We're going into a little bit of detail because...
Yes. For beginners.
Yes. Talking about more stuff.
How do mice celebrate when they move home?
How do you move home?
When they move into a new home, how do they celebrate?
I don't know how.
With a mouse-forming party. You're all spoiled with the proverbs.
I know. Oh, this mouse is a little special right now. I'm gonna have faith that I can make it right. Okay, we need to decide what color mouse. So, we've got white, which is our Serafina white. It's a very nice white for needle felting. We've got tan, that's what the soul dye looks like. We've got gray, which is what this is, the soul dye. And dark gray is for the little accents. Way more dark gray than you're ever gonna need for these little mises. So what color do you think, Milo? Help me out here. What shows up well?
Dark one. I'd say tan or gray.
Tan or gray. All right, I have a lot of gray. Let's do tan. Now that our mouse has all of his little shapes, it's time to put the top coat color on. Actually, before I do that, I want to draw his little mouth and put the pink nose on. So I'm going to take some of my dark gray. I like dark gray versus black because black is so pretty extreme. And I'm going to twist a teeny tiny little ribbon, like a little thread almost. And I'm going to stab it into the dent. There we go. I'm using a medium needle, a 36, 38. All right, and then if I want to...
Well. You're going to hear me groan now. This gross fit.
Okay. If I want to, I can make a little smile. Or a little mouth, too. Ooh, maybe he's like...
Yawning. All right, the Chinese bring it with the proverb.
Oh, okay, you found a proverb. Good.
Even when a girl is as shy as a mouse, you still have to beware of the tiger within.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good one.
Where? Okay. It's so funny because they all turn out different. Like, they just each get this little look. So, like, this one, for example, I made him have a black Popeye. Like, he's winking. And then, oh, we could do a curl. I had curls. I pulled aside a perfect curl. Okay. I'll show that, too.
Wake up.
Okay. So, we're going to do that. Oh, where did I put it? Remember my little nose? Set it aside. It's probably long gone. All right. This is okay. So I have a new little piece and I have to restack. So basically kind of pulling the fibers apart a little bit until I have the smallest possible little square. And then I take the square and I basically want to fold it. Let me get like a real piece of paper and show you. Say this is my square. I want to fold it like this to make that point. Because this is going to be hard to see.
Super zooming.
So I just fold one side over at an angle and then fold the other side over at an angle. And I have a little point.
and I'm going to put the little point right on the end of the nose, and before all this wool goes anywhere, I'm going to stab it on. Don't worry about how far this pink goes back up the head, because it gets covered with the top coat. So that little pink point comes right to the end of the nose. All right. So that's the last thing. Now I can really encourage this round. I keep stretching his head back out, but I can felt it so that he stays pretty well and curled up. And we want to put our top coat on. So I'll start with the back. I want to take a nice 2-inch piece, maybe split it in half lengthwise, and have the fringe just end near the foot. So it's okay if it's a little bit white there. They have little white underbellies, so that's okay. And then wrap over his back, and since this goes a little too far, I'm just gonna pull some of it off, and this fringe will end near the other foot. So this is just some stabbing and time getting this. And it covers that end of the tail that we stabbed on. And then just let the fringe blend into the white. And then I'm going to go over the back. I can use that other half of the 2-inch piece. I probably don't need it quite as wide. So just going across. Thinking about keeping them curled up as I stab, kind of encouraging that curl. I have a little lock here that's tan tipped, which if you have one, you can put it, give him a little character. So I'm going to put that on in a second. But first, I'm going to take a little bit of tan, and just go across the nose. So for the nose, I need very little because it's not much space. But basically, I'm just trying to cover that pink. And let the fringe go off to each side and just kind of blend away. Get a little bit more. And then I want to go across the eyes, same thing. Letting it go right over those little eye bumps that we put on. We need to maybe we need to add some intensity to our videos with, like, you know, like on reality TV shows when there's like deadlines.
Oh.
You know.
You've only got about 5 minutes.
We've only got 5 minutes to make this right.
Stab yourself.
I know, right? I'm going to put a little bit. I like to let a little bit of top coat actually go up onto the ears, because mice kind of have a little bit of fur that goes up onto their ears, and also it just helps the ears look a little bit more incorporated. Look, see how I just kind of let it roll around that. Do you see?
Yes. Everyone is watching.
And then I'm going to put my little... Oh, he's so fuzzy. He needs a lot of stabbing. Put my little curl on. I'm going to cut a little bit of the end off because it's just a lot. And then I can tease that end out and decide how much I want to stick up. Felt that on, and then I'll cover the gray with tan.
Everyone's sleeping. So these are so cool because, well, they're adorable. And they're cool for Christmas because you can just kind of tuck them in a tree or, you know, make little ornaments out of them. But really, they're awesome for gift giving. They don't take long. And like I said, if you spread the joy, the world will be a better place. And they can go anywhere, like any season. They could just live on your desk and make you happy.
They look very cute with pumpkins.
They do look cute with pumpkins, with nests. See, we have this little nest that our friend Dusty made. See how cute they are? Okay, so almost done. Eyes, we want to stab the little closed eye into the eye bump, and I usually give it a slight arc, so slight rainbow, and then it gets the dark gray line.
Oh, it's very sleepy.
And you will just want to make these all day, so you're going to call out from work. And you're gonna get fired. Don't call me when you lose your job. We should have a warning.
Yes.
But the good news is you're gonna make so many friends when you give them these.
Maybe they'll let you live at their house when
you lose your house.
You lose your house after losing your job. That's kind of like if you give your, what is that book? You give a mouse a cookie.
Yeah.
If you felt a mouse.
If you felt a mouse.
You're gonna have to.
You know, you could stay warm on the streets with all your mice surrounding you.
This is true.
So this turned out pretty cute, Milo. I like it.
Yes.
He looks kind of like you.
Yep.
He could be your friend.
Thank you.
You could snuggle.
I don't think that would last long.
No?
No.
Too tempting?
Yes, indeed.
So just a reminder, you can make them smaller. You can work on a skewer and start with more like a 6-inch piece. Same steps, quarter it, you know, and wrap the head and the body. It's just all going to be smaller. And you might make the tail on a toothpick instead of a skewer. So just scale it down. We can see how small people can go, really.
What if they made the body on a toothpick?
That would be impressive.
Someone's going to try it.
If you want to learn more about what we do, you can go to serafinafiberart.com, and that's also where you can get the supply pack and any of the tools that you might need, any wool you might need. And you can find us on Facebook. Our Facebook page is Serafina Fiber Art, and our Facebook group is Serafina Felting Fanfare, and we share our projects there and ideas and can ask questions. There's a lot to get out of the group. Both of those Facebook pages are also where we post our Fiber Fairy giveaway, which is on some Fridays, not all Fridays. So, lots of good stuff.
There's going to be a lot of sleepy mice on Facebook soon.
Yes. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.